In a world where Instagram and Facebook have become indispensable, we know that photos are often edited and that you can use a filter to make a picture look completely different. Depending on which filter or lens you use, you will get a totally different representation of the same reality. Hi, Keo Dovann here, and welcome to another episode of Week at a Glance, where we dive into a thoughtful summary of this week's Bible study guide. I'm so happy to see all of your smiling faces. You may be watching this from the comfort of your own home or at your local church. I'm glad that you are here. And if this is your first time joining us, welcome. In this episode, we will talk about the eyes of the Lord, the biblical worldview. This is an old camera. Your smartphone can take better picture quality than this. But one major advantage of this is that it has interchangeable lenses. Photographers know which lens to use for a specific photo shoot. They also know which filters to use to enhance the picture. Good lenses produce good images. Bad and wrong lenses create bad images. This one right here is a good lens. Well, this one here has a fungus building up inside, so it's a bad lens. The picture that I take with this lens is not a perfect representation of the reality that I'm trying to capture. What lens are you using right now to understand and interpret reality? Now, here are the important points to remember for today's episode. Point number one is creation, the foundation of biblical worldview. As human beings, you and I look at the world with different pairs of glasses. These glasses act as a filter in how we understand and interpret the world around us. This is commonly referred to as worldview. Your worldview will determine how you answer the important questions on origin, identity, meaning, morality, and destiny. This is why, for Christians, it is very important to be firmly grounded in the biblical worldview. But how do you know what is the biblical worldview? The answer is actually very simple, yet it is very important. Through the Bible. For Seventh-day Adventists, the Bible remains the foundational text of our faith. It teaches the worldview, the filter, by which we see and also understand the world. The Bible opens up with creation. It introduces God as the creator of everything. This is such a foundational doctrine because everything that we believe as Christians rests on the six-day creation and God as the creator. Without this foundational doctrine, all other doctrines don't make any sense. But what happened to God's perfect creation? What is the purpose of life? Were we just created to grow old and die? Our next point will help us answer this question. Point number two is redemption, the center of biblical worldview. Although the doctrine of creation is very foundational to our faith, it does not appear alone. It is directly tied to the doctrine of redemption. In order to appreciate redemption, you and I need to understand that we are born on a planet in rebellion. From a Christian viewpoint, redemption is salvation from sin, and sin is whatever is against God's moral law. Right from the start, God's moral law has been in existence. It is a reflection of God's character. It is the standard between right and wrong. After the fall of mankind, the great principles of God's law are embodied in the Ten Commandments and exemplified in the life of Christ. Now, let's talk about redemption. Why would the Creator die for this rebellious planet? This is because He is the God of love, and His love is manifested in His mercy and also His justice. Now, this is where it gets a little tricky. The God of mercy must forgive sinners, but the God of justice must punish sinners to uphold His law. How can He be the God of mercy and at the same time be the God of justice? The answer, through the life and death of Jesus. God showed that sinners could be forgiven without changing His law. He took the punishment upon Himself for man's redemption. This is the Creator we are talking about here. John chapter 1 says, "Through Him all things were made, and without Him nothing was made that has been made." The one who made everything was the one who died on the cross for you and me. Now think about that. I could only think of one response, and that is to worship Him. First, I worship Him because He is the Creator. And second, I worship Him because He saved me. For this reason, the doctrine of salvation or the doctrine of redemption is the heart and the center of the biblical worldview. In point number one and point number two, we address four important areas that comprise a worldview. origin, identity, meaning, and morality. Our origin is not because of a cosmological accident, but through a creator. Our identity is in God. We are God's children, made in His image. We have a meaning created by God with a purpose, and our morality is guided by God's moral law. But there's one area that we didn't discuss yet, and that is destiny. We know that God created us and redeemed us. But what's next? Where are we going? Let's move on to our final point to discover what's next. Our third and final point is restoration, the object of biblical worldview. The good news about biblical worldview is that it is a well-thought-out package. It builds up to a finale, and that is the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. We are not meant to just live and die. God wants to restore the perfect condition of humanity before the fall of Adam and Eve. And He is coming back again to reclaim what belongs to Him. And this process of restoration has actually already begun. It is also the goal of Christian education to help restore in man the image of his Maker, to bring you and me back to the perfection in which we were once created. The true object of education is to restore the image of God in the soul. And this is why the biblical worldview is very important in Adventist education. It is a known fact that there's no such thing as neutral perspective. All of life, all of reality is viewed through the lens or through the filter of one's worldview. For this reason, the biblical worldview is central in Adventist education. This means that all general fields of education, science, history, morality, culture, and so forth, will be taught from that perspective. As discussed in previous episodes, Christian education is a lifelong process of learning. This is why even if you are no longer in school, this is still relevant. It is so crucial that we teach our younger people and even older church members the biblical worldview. Worldviews are like lenses. The exact same facts or evidences that you find in archaeology, biology, geology, morality, and other fields of studies can be very differently interpreted depending on the lens through which we view them. So, take the camera of God and start using the lens that God has provided you. Look through the lens of God. Look through the eyes of the Lord. In summary, here are different points that we talked about in today's episode on the eyes of the Lord. Point number one, creation, the foundation of biblical worldview. Point number two, redemption, the center of biblical worldview. And third, restoration, the object of biblical worldview. If you find this episode helpful, then please share it with your friends so that they too will start seeing through the eyes of the Lord. Spread the word and change lives one message at a time. And if you want to learn about the role of the law in Christian education, then click on this video right here. And if you have any questions, comments, or answers, then be sure to leave a message below, because your questions and insights will help others who will discover this video later. This is again Keo Dovann for Week at a Glance. I'll see you again next week.